Good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of Emkay Global Financial Services, I take the opportunity to welcome you all to discuss the FY21 results of TRF Limited with Mr. Alok Krishna, Managing Director, Mr. N.S. Raghu, Chief Financial Officer, and Mr. Subhashish Datta, Company Secretary and Chief Commercial. We thank the management for providing us with the opportunity to host the call. A reminder that today's session is being recorded. We request the management for opening remarks, which can be followed by a Q&A session. Over to you, sir.
This meeting is being recorded.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Alok Krishna, Managing Director of Tata Steel, TRF. At the outset, we offer our positive thoughts and best wishes to all our stakeholders as the ongoing COVID-19 global health pandemic continues to cause unprecedented disruptions to our daily lives and business. We remain deeply committed to the health and safety of our employees and the communities we operate in. We hope you and your loved ones are safe and healthy. The past 15 months has been dramatic and stressful in a way we have not experienced before. We are collectively facing overwhelming challenges and hardships. The human toll alone is difficult to accept, and vulnerabilities in healthcare and social safety nets across the globe has been laid bare. At the same time, we experienced the new normal that we could not have imagined, from scientific breakthroughs to new ways of learning, living, and working. The spread of the COVID-19 pandemic created uncertainty, disruption, and volatility to our business during the financial year 2021. Global growth plunged 3.5% year-on-year in 2020, the deepest global recession since the Great Depression. India's GDP for financial year 2021 is estimated to have contracted by around 7.5% on a year-on-year basis. Poor visibility on a time frame for a cure or prevention further complicates assessment of its impact and our ability to prognosticate potential recovery. However, witnessing the Herculean efforts, resource commitment, and the collective will of political, medical, and social stakeholders across the globe to surmount this challenge gives us a hope that this crisis will also be behind us sooner than later. In the backdrop of the pandemic and emergency lockdown regulations enforced by the central and state governments, the company has gradually resumed its operation after the lockdown regulations were lifted in June 2020 and continued its manufacturing operations at its works plant at Jamshedpur, Jharkhand, and all the projects at customer sites. Protecting the health and safety of our employees was our key focus from the outset of the pandemic and continues to remain our top priority. With the further resurgence of the second wave of COVID-19, we have reinstituted all necessary safeguards and precautionary measures to minimize its impact. Work from home continues to be the default mode of working across all service functions, and we are not rushing to bring people back to office. Roster systems have been introduced in the manufacturing area. Our clear focus is on raising the awareness of our employees and their families through regular communication and safeguarding well-being by promoting vaccination. Going forward, we intend to comply with our manufacturing and execution plans and to make all efforts to improve our cost structure and preserve cash, which remains the key focus in the current context of our business as in the last year. The company will continue to monitor the impact of COVID-19 and any material changes to future economic conditions. The Board of Directors of TRF Limited, at its meeting held on May 31, 2021, had approved the standalone and consolidated financial results for the quarter and financial year ended March 31, 2021. I would like to present the TRS performance. On a standalone basis, the company recorded a turnover of rupees 114 crore for the financial year 2021 against rupees 186.41 crore for the financial year 2019-20. The company incurred loss after tax of rupees 67.96 crores for the financial year 2021 against rupees 132.64 crore for the financial year 2019-20. On a consolidated basis, the company recorded a turnover of rupees 114 crore for the financial year 2021 against rupees 186.41 crore for the financial year 2019-20. The company incurred loss after tax of rupees 65.51 crore during the year ended March 31, 2021 against rupees 132.47 crore for the financial year 2019-20. During the year under review, the company divested the entire stake held by Dutch Lanka Trailer Manufacturers Limited, Sri Lanka, which is a step-down, wholly owned subsidiary of the company, in Tata International DLT Private Limited, a 50-50 joint venture company of Tata International Limited and Dutch Lanka Trailer Manufacturers Limited. Hence, Tata DLT ceased to be a joint venture of the group with effect from January 2021. Looking at the performance of the subsidiary, Dutch Lanka Trailer Group, the turnover for the financial year FY 2021 stands at 43.52 crore against 56 crore in FY 19-20. And the profit loss before tax stands at a loss of 1.13 crore in FY 2021 against a profit of 1.12 in FY 19-20. On the project front, we have successfully completed several projects during the year. On the external projects front, we completed projects of Bhel at Meja, Vanakbori, and two out of the seven circuits at Nagarnar NMDC site were completed, while the ship unloader was completed at IFFCO Paradeep. At the NTPC Nabi Nagar Power Generating Company, NPGC site, the first rake of bottom discharge wagons was unloaded at the track hopper, while the commercial operation of the second unit of 660 megawatt commenced through the coal handling system provided by TRF. Some of the noteworthy projects executed for Tata Steel are erection and commissioning of wagon loader at West Bokaro, it's a colliery, booster pump house and pipeline work for in-pit slime dam at iron ore mines Joda, and refurbishment of wagon tippler at Tata Steel Jamshedpur. Through effective engagement with Steel Authority of India Limited Bokaro, we achieved a major breakthrough by resuming supplies and could liquidate finished goods worth rupees 500 crore lying with TRF for more than 2 years. We reduced overall inventories by around 30% as compared to FY20. Despite significant challenges, the company has been able to recover over 150 crores during the year under review. We are in continuous engagement with our key customers like NTPC, BHEL, NMDC, DVC, etc., for expediting collection of old critical debtors. We have been able to realize a considerable amount of retention money from NPGC Nabi Nagar and recently from NTPC Bar. But on the whole, we experienced delay in customer payments due to the pandemic as some customers endured financial difficulties. We are, however, continuing to pursue with them. This has resulted in reduction in BG exposure by nearly 40 crore, which is 16% as compared to March 20. Our deep focus on austerity measures an aggressive pursuit of cost reduction helped us to identify and squeeze all unwanted spends. Overall, we achieved nearly 22% reduction in fixed overhead costs compared to last financial year. Going forward, the company plans to expedite execution of all major projects based on priority and concentrate on deeper engagement with Tata Steel on securing such orders which will help improve effective utilization of its production capacity and deployment of human capital in design engineering and project management areas productively. This will help in mitigating the commercial and financial risks with better capital turnaround and cash flows. We will continue our focus on A, cost reduction as a business priority, B, remaining a responsive organization to meet customers' need by improving our delivery performance, and C, exploring options for further restructuring of subsidiary, and D, giving impetus to improve employee engagement, motivation, and thereby enhancing productivity levels. We seek shareholders' relentless support in our turnaround journey. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We will be opening the Q&A session for participants. Anyone who has a question, please use the raise hand option. Once the participant is called out, please unmute yourself to ask a question. Yes, please go ahead.
Hello.
Yes, please go ahead.
Yeah, my question is for Mr. Alok Krishna.
Yes, please go ahead.
Yeah, sir, you mentioned that we seek shareholders' relentless support. Can you hear me?
Yes, please go ahead.
Yeah, yeah. Sir, you have mentioned that we seek shareholders' relentless support in our turnaround journey. Sir, we have been supporting you for the last 10 years. But sir, when it comes to certain disclosures, the company is reluctant to share with shareholders like us who have been with your company for the last 10 years and who have seen the market capitalization come down by 90%. So my simple question to you is that when is the company turning around? And sir, what can we expect in the next 1, 2, 3 years? You know, if you can throw some clarity or throw some light on this, where is this company headed, sir? Because 65 crore of loss last year, and who knows, probably this year also we could end up in loss. So when can we expect this turnaround, you know, which we have been expecting for the last now 5 years, you know, and for the last 10 years we have been patient. So sir, if you can give some idea about the future, we'll be really obliged.
No, it is a very, very relevant question. And if you look at our journey, especially in the last 1 year, if you look at our losses, we have reduced our losses by almost about 50%. And if you look at our EBITDA performance also, we have made an improvement in our EBITDA by almost about 65%. And this is in the backdrop of such a challenging year. While the company had been passing through some very difficult times, the onslaught of COVID-19 actually it caused much more pain to the company in our fledgling, I would say, recovery. Despite the challenges, we have put our best effort. And if you look at some of the numbers which we have presented this year, other than the PBT and the improvement in EBITDA, I mean, we continue to be in losses, but there has been a significant improvement. If you look at the project, on the project front, the amount of project that we have delivered, it is quite significant. And most of the projects, we had to incur the lockdowns or the slowdown because of the initial period and labor migration, all those kind of challenges were there. We had a huge amount of challenges to face in terms of disruption in the supply chain. Nevertheless, the company, the management, we were all very much focused. One of the ways by which we tried to bring about significant improvement is how we can improve the cash flows. And while our turnover was just about 114 crore, if you look at the total collections that we made, was over 150 crores, right? So we were able to realize some of our working capital, which was blocked in terms of inventories. So there was a huge exercise which was undertaken, engaged with the customers to help liquidating some of these inventories. The journey continues. It is our sincere endeavor that how quickly we can come back into an EBITDA positive position. And there was a need, to reprioritize our priorities in terms of taking up orders which have a shorter turnaround and which are not fraught with too much of risk. So these initiatives, they have started yielding the results, and we are quite confident that in some time to come, you will be able to see the company to be much more healthier than what it has been in the past.
Fine, sir. Good to hear this positive comments coming from you, sir. I had two questions more. One is, what is the net consolidated debt of the company? Because the finance cost is at 38 crores. So what is the net consolidated debt? One. And secondly, in the last quarter, we did a revenue of about 60 crores. So this year, can we expect about 250-300 crores of top line?
So on the net, you said net debt or gross
net debt? Consolidated debt.
I am requesting our CFO. Maybe he can take on that. Yeah. Mr. Raghu, are you up there?
Yeah. Just a minute, sir. So we have a consolidated debt of almost 199 crores of the short-term borrowing. So around 240 crores is the net debt for the consolidated business.
Sir, 240 crores of debt. So why is the finance cost 38 crores?
Pardon?
Then in that case, why is the finance cost so high? 38 crores is the finance cost.
Yeah.
So what are we paying, 14% on the debt?
No. So see, what you need to also realize, the actual finance cost is much less. We are actually having a finance cost by way of provision for the MSME vendors for the delayed payments which we are making.
Achha, okay.
So this is actually not a, these are more of provisions in the books.
Achha.
We are not actually paying this interest.
Achha. So 250 okay. crore is the net consolidated debt.
That's on the higher side. So okay. What you're looking at is on the higher side.
Achha.
So if the 38 crores, you just have to take out almost 6 crores plus of this. This is one time. This is actually not a finance cost. It's not a cost which is being paid to a bank.
Okay, okay.
Where we do the accounting, you are aware of this. So the provisions for the MSME is a statutory one.
Okay.
So we have to make those provisions.
Yeah.
These are not paid.
Okay. Fine, sir. My second question was on the expected turnover for the current.
Just to add on that borrowing, you will be happy to note that despite the challenges, we were able to reduce our borrowings by almost about 15% during the year.
Right, sir. So my second question was on expected turnover for the current year, because last quarter you did quite well, 60 crore compared to 50 crore in the last quarter of 19-20. So can we expect a 300 crores top line in the current year if things are improving now?
Sir,
if you may allow me.
Okay.
We generally will not give a forward-looking statement around this. That is number one. Number two is last quarter was a good quarter because we were able to work in somewhat near normal circumstances.
Okay.
Again, current quarter, because of the COVID impact, we are very badly impacted.
Achha.
So we will not give you any forward-looking statement around this. But this is, I just wanted to preempt Alok sir in mentioning this. Sir, you may want to reply. You can add to whatever I have said.
No, I just wanted to add to actually, Raghu, you have already mentioned it. In the sense, whatever momentum we were able to generate at the end of the quarter four of last financial, most of it we lost. As soon as the new financial started, and all of us, we are aware at this time, the impact of COVID was much more lethal, much more deeper, and it has really disrupted in a big way. It has really disrupted in a big way. We all know, I mean, we have a huge dependence on oxygen.
Right.
Anywhere, whether it is manufacturing, whether it is project site, construction activity, oxygen is the lifeline, just like human. But we are conscious that the priority of oxygen would have been to save human lives and not to, you know, divert it into an activity which could have waited for some time. So I think the government also took the right decision in those areas. So it has impacted. We are now gradually we are now trying to come back, because you will understand that once these disruptions happen, the supply chain is so intertwined. I mean, it is not just TRF on a standalone, but we are completely integrated with our supply chain partners.
Right.
So there is a huge dependence on how quickly they can come back. While we may say that, okay, we are better prepared, but we have to also see that many of our supply chain vendors and partners, they may not be all that lucky. Okay. But we have to wait, and we have to see that all of us will come back together. And definitely it will be our endeavor that how we can we can bring the company back to its normal state of operations.
Fine, sir. Fine. Anything you would like to mention on order book position, sir? At least we can get some idea how are the orders on hand right now.
We have over 200 crores of orders.
Okay. Okay.
Projects and services and what we call as our products and spares. So from an order book perspective, I would still say that it is a healthy state. It is only that the challenges of supply chain and how much we are able to therefore execute.
Fine, sir. Thank you so much.
March quarter, you saw we were able to execute well.
Right.
After 4 or 5 months of struggle, we were able to realign everything. And as we all say, that looks like all these stars, they came together, right?
Right.
I'm not so gung-ho in quarter one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fine, sir. Yeah, all the best to you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. A reminder that once the participant is called out, please unmute yourself to ask a question and mention your firm's name as well. This question is from Himesh. Please go ahead.
Hello, sir. I'm an individual investor. So I just want to know.
We are not able to hear you, Mr. Himesh.
Are you able to hear me now?
Not very clear.
Maybe a little bit louder.
Yeah, I just wanted to ask you, are you looking at any more divestments in any other joint ventures or subsidiaries?
Mr. Himesh, we are restructuring our portfolio for the simplification. So there are certain things. So as and when the things will materialize, we'll come back.
Okay. And the second thing that, you know, so now as far as the future orders are concerned, are we going to be, looking more at, our parent company Tata Steel for orders? Or are we also going to look at other companies like NTPC and BHEL? So I just want to know, where are we looking at business now?
Let me take that. So, Mr. Himesh, you can understand it is all about managing the risk.
Right.
In the past, a large portfolio of our exposure was in these spaces. I mean, we were more like EPC partners than anything else. And these projects are fraught with its own set of challenges, right? So definitely there is a need that we do a portfolio restructuring in such a way that, you know, we have, let's say, a capital adequacy and our cash flow situation is much more improved at a much lower risk. To that extent, we will take any action, and even if it means that we will be looking towards more from Tata Steel, that is also a distinct possibility. We are not going to draw any line. I mean, if you look at my order book position even today, we are almost about 50-50. And if you look at the flow of new orders also, we are almost around the same proportion. You know, give or take 5% here or there. But we have been participating in all these NTPCs or public sector orders as much as we will be participating for orders of Tata Steel. But definitely we will be looking at our risk profile, our underlying risk, and we will be taking decisions by which we do not lose money. Our primary objective will be to generate incremental cash flows, not just on the paper, but cash flow. That is the whole idea.
Okay, yeah. And just the last question. So what do you think will be the normalized margins for the company? Because, you know, in the past, we've seen because of a lot of delays and other issues that we've actually, lost money, because of all that. So what will be the normalized margins for the new business that you now, secure?
It depends. See, it will depend. I don't think there will be one single number. It will depend. And like any other company, you know, wherever we are a OEM kind of a thing, where we have some advantage, the margin may be higher. Wherever we have to play, let's say, in a very, very competitive environment, the margin will be very, very low. But again, what we are trying to see is that we don't place a bet on something where eventually we will be losing money. Right.
Right.
So maybe we are not interested in volume now. Because by volume, if we lose money, I don't think we can come back to the shareholders and say, oh, see, our top line has been great, but we have lost money. So we are focusing more on how we can just generate whatever little we generate, but we generate. We do not lose.
Okay. Thank you so much and all the best, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Amish. The next question is from Jaisal. You may go ahead.
Good afternoon. This is I am from NVS Brokerage Private Limited, BSE NSE member. Sir, I wanted to just understand that you have said that, you know, we are on journey to now, you know, the turnaround or recovery, whatever we may call. But if you can just throw some more, little more, I would say that little more detailed map, if you can, roadmap, if you can lay down that in how, you know, we propose to actually turn around in terms of, say, more engagement of the manpower, because if there was excess manpower, or maybe the orders which were loss making have been now completed and the new orders with better margins are generated. What kind of, this thing, again, the first quarter had seen some lockdown, so I'm sure that you have also must have been impacted. But we just want to understand little broader detail that what kind of a roadmap to turn around we are likely to have. And when are we going to see at least, you know, I mean, company break even, if not, you know, make profit. But when do we see the break even, either in the current year or some more time is going to go? Secondly, to take care of the, you know, I mean, accumulated losses of earlier years, etc. Are we planning to pump in some more capital, maybe by way of a rights issue or any other issue or something? Or what is the your plans for, you know, like more beefing up more capital?
So may I request Shivashish, you go ahead and then I'll join.
Thanks to Mr. Professor for your question. The first one is that our focus is to complete this all these projects as fast as possible, so that whatever the loss we are incurred earlier, that will be as MD has mentioned in the opening remark, that we have completed most of the legacy projects. However, there are two legacy projects which are there, the Nominagos and Naganga. That also we are trying to complete within this financial year. And suppose something left over, then that is the next financial year. That is the first priority. Other legacy projects based on the customer, that whatever the commercial issues and the availability of the fund, we are also trying to complete it. So that once the legacy project will be over, then we are sharing the new set, and then that whatever the new order can be mentioned, that this should be the profitable and the risk profile and this thing. So there we are sure that we make money. This is number one. Second is that regarding this right issue, as you know that it is normally the promoter they have to take a call. So we are not in a position right now to comment on the right issue. If suppose there is any proposal of such nature, definitely we will come back. Yeah.
So legacy projects, which were the loss-making units, is it over, or you feel that it is still more some time to go before the end of the, you know, when legacy projects, loss-making projects are executed, completed, and we are completely out of that?
No, so we are in the advanced stage of completing the legacy project.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Some of the projects we have been able to complete, but you can understand that completion of one partner is not good enough.
Correct.
So there are dependencies in many of the projects. We have completed our scope of the contract,
mm-hmm.
but we'll have to wait for others.
Okay.
But I can only assure you, at least there will be no further cost which
Correct.
Will be incurred on those projects. And there are just a handful of projects
mm-hmm.
which also with the COVID impact now coming down,
mm-hmm.
we have plans to finish them off as quickly as possible, possibly
okay.
during this year itself.
Okay. Normally, sir, your projects executions are short term in the sense like 6 to 9 months or within a year?
No. The projects that we are talking about may be running for the last 6 years, 7 years, 8 years.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So legacy so, is about really legacy.
Okay.
So just to add, now we are not taking that sort of long projects with
okay.
projects with long gestation.
Uh-huh.
We are doing lot smaller orders is what we are taking, but the legacy is something where we still have to complete
yes.
Certain projects which will take time.
Correct.
So may move its place spill over into the next financial year also.
Okay.
So that's what we wanted to highlight.
Yeah. So in terms of the now new projects as well as whatever exercise you have done and you are continuing to do to turn around the company, do you see that at the end of March 22, we can see at least maybe break even, if not make profit, like on a at least on a this thing?
Would not like
level?
To comment. Would not like to comment on that. You are aware. We would not like to comment on that.
Okay, sir. Can I say the other way around? Can I just ask other way around?
Yeah.
What is the internal target that when
no,
you
so
feel
what,
that comfort to be black?
So these are price sensitive information. We don't give forward looking statements. Our intention
okay.
is to try and at least become EBITDA positive. So
okay.
maybe if not this year, next year we'll surely become EBITDA positive. But
okay.
this is not a statement from our side. Okay.
Okay. But are we do we expect any kind of you know, like impairment or any such charges, etc., in the current year or so?
As of now, probably the answer is no.
Okay.
But we may still have something if as things evolve, if things worsen, then we may have certain things. As of now, the answer would be probably the chance of some major impairments coming through is less.
Excellent. Thank you very much, sir, and all the best to you in your
Thank you, Mr. Shah. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from Aditya. Aditya, you may go ahead.
Sir, thank you very much for giving me an opportunity. I just wanted to know about, you mentioned about the this order book of around 200 crores. So what will be the legacy order out of this, and what will be the incremental order which may be completed, say, within say 12 to 18
about,
months?
About 60% is legacy orders.
60% is legacy order.
Yeah.
Okay.
Of that, and out of that, we definitely see that a major part of it. What we want to do, Mr. Kulkarni, I would also want to say that some of these legacy orders may be fraught with a lot of dangers. So as the as to safeguard the shareholders' wealth, we would not want to go ahead with some of these high risk projects till such time that there is a clarity on cash flows.
Okay, so what might be the amount of these projects? 40 crore?
About 50 crore, 40 to 50 crore is what we are watching very closely. We are engaging with the customers, right? And in my speech, I mentioned, Mr. Kulkarni, we had a similar situation with one of our key public sector units. We engaged with the company directly, and that has helped us to liquidate more than 5 crores of inventory, and we continue to do that. So we will to safeguard the wealth of our shareholders in whatever way possible, we will engage with the customers and we will work out solutions which is value generating for the shareholders. Otherwise, we will not waste the money on some of these projects.
Okay, sir. And I just wanted to know about this, out of these 114 crores of turnover which we did last year, what was the part of Tata Steel? Was it around 40-45 crores?
Anirudh, you can give the numbers.
Yeah, sir. It is around
50 crores is Tata Steel. Sorry, I was speaking on mute. It's around 50 crores is around is from Tata Steel. The balance is from outside, external projects.
Okay. And sir, what is the amount which is blocked in the bank guarantees or performance guarantees, and which may be able, we will be able to recover within say next 3 months, 6 months or 1 year?
No, so the bank guarantee numbers are larger, but this is a long drawn process. Till the PG tests, etc. are not completed, we will not get our monies, the bank guarantee released. What we have taken up is, we've tried to engage with our customers and reduce our exposure on the various, against the various orders which we have. But till the projects don't get completed, the bank guarantee exposure still remains.
Okay, but so Raghu, just to add that yes, this with all our efforts, we were able to reduce almost about 16% of our bank guarantee.
No, so that's it, sir. I did not want to give the full number, but the exposure still remains. We have reduced our exposure, but till the projects get completed and the PG tests, etc., are completed to the satisfaction of the customers, the exposure still remains to a certain extent.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you. A reminder to the participants, anyone who wishes to ask a question may use the raise hand option. Yes, you may go ahead. Please mention your name and your phone's name.
Hello. Hello, is it audible?
Yes, you are.
Hi, this is Tinkesh Punjabi, individual investor.
Yes, Yes, Mr. Punjabi, go ahead.
Thank you for the opportunity, sir. Sir, request you please share competitive edge of DRF Limited.
Sorry, can you repeat your question? It was not very clear.
Sir, my question is on the competitive edge of a company. Could you please enlighten few points?
So, you know, I would not say competitive edge, but the model of TRF is one-stop solution. So we have a quite advanced design and engineering capability, which is supported by an integrated manufacturing. And subsequently, we are able to do large-scale projects. So from design to manufacture of equipment to, let's say, erection and commissioning, the entire solution is available under one roof. And from a expertise perspective, definitely TRF has a huge amount of established base as far as bulk material handling systems are concerned. So large power projects, large steel plants, you know, the material handling systems are generally supplied by TRF. So that is a big advantage for TRF in terms of, you know, the kind of expertise in design, manufacturing, erection and commissioning of bulk material handling equipments are concerned.
Okay. Sir, second question is about non-core assets company has. Could you please give few updates on non-core assets, including land bank, if any?
No, we don't own any land bank as on date. But yes, we have been looking at how to monetize some of our non-core assets.
Sir, could you please identify your step-down subsidiaries, which are key assets?
Sorry? Can you repeat?
Sir, could you update us with company which are key or the core assets?
I am not able. Raghu, could you get it?
Mr. Tinkesh, see, we have the operating subsidiaries as on date in Sri Lanka. They have the factory in Sri Lanka. And they are from there, they are manufacturing tailors. So they have the factory base and the land in Sri Lanka. So that is the operating subsidiaries as of now.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from Jigar. Jigar, you may go ahead.
Yeah, thank you for taking my question. We passed an enabling resolution to do business worth approximately 450 crores from Tata Steel and sales of 450 crores. So you think, sir, this current year we may execute that business, that much business with Tata Steel? That is my first question.
I'm requesting Mr. Subhashish Datta to respond on that.
Mr. Jigar, thanks for that question. As Andrew has mentioned in the opening remark, that because of this COVID, last year there was a capital pinch by Tata Steel, and that like any other contractor of Tata Steel, we were also affected because of the capital fee. However, this year, because of the steel industry, there is some upward movement. So they have let the capital token. And hopefully that will also be benefited. We have taken the enabling resolution from the shareholder. So that when the opportunity comes, so we'll get the opportunity and we can execute that whatever the possible. and we are working with Tata closely. Let's see that how it will be considered in this financial year. However, of course, there is a challenge of the second wave of the COVID that we have to keep in mind.
But in a normalized year, sir, should we expect in the vicinity of 400 crores business to be done with Tata Steel, sir?
That was the expectation. However, it all depends upon that what is their capex portion, how we are become competitive, in what way we can be a complement to each other, because they also having a set of factories and other things. So all depend upon. But we are having to have as mentioned. So we are having to enlarge our business base, the data space, because the big profile and the commercial strength and the cash flow, they will be definitely better as compared to the other external market.
So my second question is, would Tata Steel look at increasing a stake in the company and pumping in more money?
This is the promoters are called. At this juncture, we will not be able to comment on how Tata Steel takes action. However, if suppose there is something emerge, definitely we will come back to you.
How they've increased stake in Tata Metallics, sir?
We cannot comment on that.
So my one more question, sir. Are there any non-cash charges in the account, sir, in terms of debtors write-off or inventory write-off in FY21?
As we have mentioned that last year, though it was a COVID-affected year, but we have collected more than 150 crores in the debtors through our active participation for the major customers. We have just not made any major provision in the papers, and that is how that we have contained the losses. But going forward, again, we will continue to engage with the customer, and let's see that how it will be translated into the collection.
So there are no non-cash charges, sir, in FY21 in terms of debtors write-off or inventory write-off?
Not in a major way.
Okay. And sir, this 182 crores debtors outstanding, that would be retention money outstanding, sir?
That out of that 186 crores, that is the net data, out of which around 140 crores will be retention balance that we have data. That is running at the business.
So it's a mix
sir,
of
how
both.
Do you...
The mix of both the
so 140 data, crores would be retention money.
Yeah, almost around that.
Sir, my last
Jigar, thank you, Jigar.
Question, sir, how do we intend
Jigar,
correcting the balance sheet?
Jigar, I request you to
okay.
please come back
okay.
in the queue.
Okay, thank you.
The next question is from Aditya. You may go ahead.
Hello. I just wanted to know ki now looking at the upcycle in the commodity businesses where we are catering to, so how do we see this as opportunity going forward, say over the next 3 to 6 months? Are we looking seeing more inquiries coming to us for the projects or the product supply? How is business environment going looking for? That's what my question is.
Yeah, no. So as I mentioned that, you know, business environment had started looking up, but definitely there has been some kind of a setback with the onslaught of the second wave of COVID-19, right? But we continue to generate very healthy inflow of inquiries and also fresh orders. Our challenge will continue that how quickly the entire supply chain comebacks, recovers, and we are able to deliver.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Aditya. The next question is from Venkat. Please go ahead.
Hi, thanks for taking my question. At a time when a lot of competitors are in poor shape and many of them have chosen to actually withdraw from the field, you probably will get pricing power after a very long time. And some of that can only happen when we ourselves have balance sheet strength. So given our current state of balance sheet, what remedial actions are we going to take very quickly? And how do we see competitive environment?
Raghu, you will take it?
From a balance sheet perspective, again, with this sort of a balance sheet, we were actually thinking earlier, but Q4 was a good quarter. If that continued for one or two quarters, probably we would have thought and come ahead with some prospects or some capital raising thought would have come in. Because at this this sort of a position, it becomes very tough to actually think about raising some capital at this point in time. But we will, it all depends. And also it depends on the promoters, how they are looking at this part of it, because they will have to underwrite a rights issue or anything of that sort.
That's exactly the question, Mr. Datta. A time like this, if the promoters, they need to really make up their mind and then have communication going with the company, right?
Yeah.
Either it doesn't even have to be a rights issue. Why? In case they are genuinely interested in this, as an operating company, we should have known it by now, right?
Yeah, so they are very keen. They are very keenly interested in this. So from a capital perspective, probably there will be issues around pumping in further capital. But they are looking at ways and means of supporting the company. So I would not like to tell you exactly how this is going to happen, but we are the thought process is there of how to make this company a lot more competitive and turn around from the position it is. That process is the discussions, etc., are on. We would not like to tell you, because still let something fructify and then we'll come forward and reach out to all the shareholders.
Fair enough. What time frame do you have in mind for this? Because the opportunity is here and now, because you're probably one of the very few players with enough franchise value strength left in them to go across and bid some huge opportunities that are coming. So when do you think one can hear?
Please wait for some time. Let's see how things progress, and we'll reach out to you as and when things, the appropriate calls are taken, and then we'll surely reach out to the shareholders, all of you.
Do you think it'll happen before the next quarter call, sir?
No, quarter will be a difficult one, so can't comment on that. So it would, I don't think it will happen so soon.
This financial crazy?
I would not like to hazard a guess on this, because these are forward-looking statements as of now, so I would not want to say that at this point in time.
Fair enough. Thanks. I'm done. Thanks.
Thank you, Venkat. The next question, due to the shortage of time, this will be the last question. Someone named iPhone, you may go ahead. Okay, as there is no response, Jigar, you may go ahead.
Yes, sir. So we were looking to sell DLT Lanka, I think in 2019 for approximately 150 crores, which was called off, sir. So you think it will fructify this year and we should be able to raise an amount in proximity to that, sir, in the current year?
Jigar, when we were trying to sell, Tata DLT and DLT together at around 137 crores. Okay.
Yeah.
So the markets have tanked after that because of the slump in the automotive sector. And after that, COVID has struck very badly, not only in India, in Sri Lanka also. And you would be
things
aware,
are looking up. Things are looking up much better globally now, no sir?
No, so things are pretty bad in Sri Lanka even now. And you would be aware that we have gone ahead and divested Tata DLT at a consideration of 24.5 crores. So,
yeah,
a relatively a much smaller sum compared to what we were seeing at in FY19. Okay, so so the chance of getting that sort of amount in the current year is practically negligible. But we are actively engaging and looking at probably disposing of DLT Sri Lanka also. We'll come back to you as and when things rectify on
so
that.
So what amount can be expected, sir? Ballpark, approximately, I can understand.
So that's what I said. So if you saw that out of the chunk of...
So 110, 15 crores?
No. So that's what I'm saying. So we out of 150, we got the major chunk should have come from Tata DLT. So probably it will again be, if at all we do something, we don't want to hazard a guess, will be around to the tune of another 20 odd crores.
Mr. Jigar, you appreciate that we are looking for the restructuring of the subsidiaries. Mr. Dobu, what he has mentioned is that it is just one of the options. Once we crystallize this option, then we'll come back to the shareholder for that approval. Right now, it is difficult to guess any amount at this juncture.
And my last question, sir, I mean, only fear, I mean, how do we correct the balance sheets on an 11 crore equity? We have a negative 282 crores reserves, sir. How does that get corrected?
So that's what we are looking at ways and means of doing certain things. This will take some time. So things will happen. So let's see. Please wait and bear with us. I think we will. This will take some time. We may come. Some things will look up is what we are looking at.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. And all the best.
So thank you.
Thank you, Jigar. Given the paucity of time, we come to the end of the call. On behalf of MK Global, we thank the management for the opportunity and request the management for closing remarks.
So thank you everyone, all our esteemed shareholders, MK Global for providing us this platform. We will continue to work together. We will continue to look forward by which we are able to improve the health of the company. And as I mentioned, we will continue to, we are quite thankful to our shareholders who have been there with us for many, many years. And we will look forward to their support in times ahead. So thank you very much. And I wish everyone all the very best of health, and please be safe and please be healthy. Thank you very much.
Thank you, everyone. And we'll now end the call.
Thank you.
Goodbye.